Hey tubers, Big Kid here, Big Kid Reviews, and many more sites. I made a bunch of video clips as I was making this gate, but I guess the video gremlins ate it, because I have looked and looked and looked, and I don't know what happened or if it got something happened to the camera that I was using or whatever, but it disappeared. And as they say, stuff happens. But what I needed to do was we put our sheep inside this fenced, rather large yard by our house at night, because we have such a terrible coyote and predator problems, including cougars. And the only way to get them out of here and into this little pasture I refer to as the candy store. They've overgrazed it now, but otherwise there's lots of food plot stuff and all kind of things I put in there for wildlife and for winter food plot, but for the sheep. But the only way to get them out of here was to go through that gate by the chicken pen and coax them over to that gate down there and put them in. And I can't let them go in through this other way in the garden area. I do have a little gate up there, but it's they would rather eat the fruit trees, and I can't have that. We spent at least $200 buying fruit trees and planting them and replanting them. And the last batch of sheep I had ate and killed several of the trees, and we had to replant yet again. You can see some vacant spots here, and so anyway, that wasn't going to work. So I thought, well, I need a gate through this chain link fence, but it's rock over here. You only got maybe 6 inches if you got that, and then you got rock, and I'm not into the jackhammer mode anymore. And the post hole digger on the tractor won't dig it, so it's either pry bar or jackhammer it, and I'm just not up to it. So I thought about it, and this is what I come up with. And I'm using some sea purlin that you would get at your metal mart or your Mueller metal supply, or in my case, Sweetwater Steel in Northwest Central Texas, which actually the Sweetwater Steel people are actually the people that started Mueller, and they sold that, and then they got back in business and called themselves Sweetwater Steel. But that's where we got the metal for the shop and the metal for our decking on our porch and whatnot. So anyway, I always try to buy a little extra when we do a project. So this is some 3-inch sea purlin or sea channel. It's not really channel, because it's got the curve on the end here, so that's why they call it sea purlin, I guess, right there. So I thought, well, I'd make a frame out of that, and then I had some angle iron. You can see that interior gate that's hinged there, and I put some support brackets and some heavy-duty hinges. Took me several days to come up with this, and then I had some of this 4x4 wire, and first one thing and another, scraps from other projects, and I used that to put it in there to keep you know, some of the bigger varmints from getting through here. And that's worked out pretty good. But I built the whole frame out of the 3-inch, and then I had to have a way of attaching it, and I didn't want to cut that top bar on the fence and then have to go back and shore it up, and plus you'd lose your stability here without a post. So I decided I would use a pinch method to clamp the chain link to the back side, to the flat side of the sea purlin. I come around on this side over here and fit it up against, and you can hopefully see I just got some flat iron here and match the holes that I cut in the sea purlin and run bolts through there. And you can see over on that side it's bowed a little bit, but it's got that wire, the chain link, clamped in there really good. And for up here, I just tie wired the thing to that top rail for security. Then I put me some swing stops here so the gate don't go through the wrong way, and then put a little latch assembly there on that side. Screwed all them bolts down real good and tight, and then all you got to do is take one of those wires out. And let me show you how that looks. You pull out the wire, actually you take two of them out, and you leave these pointed edges where you can stick them out and bend them back over on both sides. And you do that, if you cut it, and it could come unraveled if you're not careful, but I didn't want a sharp edge to cut my sheep as they go in and out. And then I got the bottom bar there for more stability. And this gate opens nice and got braces on there, so when they rub on it, it won't get anybody cut or anything. And installed it, took that section of chain link out, and now I got myself a gate. Let the animals come in here. Get that bolt back in there. Got a lock nut. Got one sheep that's the, I call her Bobby because she's got bob tail, but she's really a ponderer. She's very smart, and she'll come over here and she watches you take that thing apart, and then she'll come over here and nose that bolt and try to get it open so she can go into that field there. So we do have a lock nut we put on there if we're going to be gone. Otherwise, she'll figure out how to open it up and help herself to that. And a long time ago, we needed an easy way to get the chickens in and out of the pen over here. Until they learn how to fly up to the top of the chain link fence. And you can see there, there's a little bitty one that I'd made for there, and a little trap door. And that dadgum Bobby, the ponderer, will actually go in and out over there if you're not careful. So we have to tie that down if we don't want them in here. But anyway, it's the easy way to fix you a gate. A situation like that where you got to drill post and get a gate and hinge and all that and make it the right size, it's a lot of trouble there. But if you don't have a welder and cutting torch and either a metal saw or a grinder with a cutting wheel on it, it's a lot of trouble to make these gates too. Another example of a good old redneck school of engineering comes through again and makes hard things simpler. Just thought I'd make a clip to show you. I've been wanting to do that but couldn't find my clip, so here we are making another one. So hit that subscribe button and like and share and plus and all those things. Thumbs up always appreciated. And we'll see you on the next one. And Big Kid will be signing out. Here it is, just a few days before Christmas. So Merry Christmas to everybody. Happy New Year, and be safe out there. And expecting 3 or 4 days of chances of rain. We sure need it because the cow and the sheep have grazed this thing down to something pretty bad. We need moisture, need it bad. So maybe we'll get it without any heavy ice and stuff. All right, we're out. See you later. Thanks for watching.